Hi, today we start solving quadratic equations by factoring. So let's get to it. I want to solve a squared minus 6a plus 9 equals 0. Okay, well, this is a perfect square trinomial. The square root of a squared is a, and the square root of 9 is 3. Now, if the middle term, not looking at the sign, equals 2 times 3 times a, then I have a perfect square trinomial. That's the test. So, I now know that a squared minus 6a plus 9 equals a minus 3 squared equals 0. Now take what's in parentheses and set it equal to 0 and solve. That's our answer. However, suppose you just feel insecure about that and you want to use the calculator. Well, let's do it. I'm going to click on y equals, and I already have it here. 1 times 9 is 9. R1, 1 times 9 is 9. So 9 over x and x plus 9 over x. Let's go to second graph. And there's a 6, but my b number is negative 6. So let's look for negative 6. Ah, there we go. And look at this. We have a negative 3 and a negative 3. Now what that says is that a squared minus 6a plus 9 factors into a minus 3 times a minus 3. And of course, a squared minus 6a plus 9 equals 0, so I can't forget the equals 0. Then set each factor equal to 0. A minus 3 equals 0. A minus 3 equals 0. So that when you solve this little equation, you get a equals 3. And when you solve this little equation, you get a equals 3. And that's the only thing you can get because these two factors are identical. So our answer, the solution to the quadratic equation, is 3. So let's click, say 3, and check answer. Oh, nice work. Okay, I'm going to go on to 2. All right, it looks for all the world like a more complicated graphing by, factoring by grouping. Okay, but now we've got a quadratic. We're going to factor it by grouping, and it's 4 r squared plus 33 r plus 54 equals 0. Okay. Onward. We'll bring the whole calculator over because the little screen keeps disappearing. All right. Going to say y equals, I'm going to clear, and I'm going to clear, and then I'm going back up to y1. My a number is 4, my c number is 54. And remember, we put ac over x, and then x plus ac over x. So I am going to click on 4 times 54 divided by x, and then come down, and I'll have x plus 4 times 54 divided by x. Nope, that was times. Go backward. Divided by x. There we go. Now, second graph. My B number is 33. I need to find positive 33 over here in Y2. So let's see if I go down. Yeah, there's 33, and it's accompanied by 9 and 24. So that means that my middle numbers are going to be 9 and 24. So I'll say 4r squared plus 24r plus 9r plus 54 equals 0. Now I put parentheses around the first two terms, parentheses around the second two terms. I'm very careful to leave the plus sign in the middle. Factor the first two terms in the first set of parentheses by greatest common factor. Pull out a 4r, and we'll have r plus 6. Now double check that. 4r times r is 4r square, and 4r times 6 is 24r. Now, I copy my plus sign, and I factor the second set of parentheses by the greatest common factor, the GCF. And that's going to be 9, because 9 is in both of these numbers. So I pull out the 9, and I'm left with r plus 6. And that equals 0. Now, I have r plus 6 and r plus 6 in parentheses. They match, so they are the new GCF. I write down r plus 6 in parentheses, and then I write the leftovers 4r plus 9. Parentheses closed. Now, if all we were doing was factoring, we'd be done. But we're not doing that anymore. We're solving a quadratic equation. So, I'm going to set each individual factor equal to 0. There. And then I'll solve each of these little equations. This one will give me r equals negative 6. This one I'm going to have to work at a little bit. I'll subtract 9 and I'll subtract 9. So I'll have 4r equals negative 9, and then divide by 4, and divide by 4, so that r equals negative 9/4. So I have two solutions. I have r equals negative 6, and I'm way down there. There I am. R equals negative 6 and R equals negative 9/4. Let's put that into the answer box and see what it says. Negative 6, comma, negative fraction 9/4. Okay, moment of truth. Woohoo! That's always nice to see. Okay, I think we have time for one more. Though I'm sure you're getting the idea. We are now going to apply. Wait a minute, let me clear my calculator. Okay. We are now going to apply the zero principle. You'll see what I mean in just a second. Let me get my paper here. All right, we are going to solve the equation 8w squared equals 12 plus 20w. What the zero principle says is this. You can't solve this quadratic equation. You cannot. Until you pull both of these terms over here and set the whole equation equal to zero. So let's just do it. I'm going to subtract 20w from both sides, and I'm going to subtract 12 from both sides of the equation so that I get a zero over here. Meanwhile, I now have on the left-hand side 8w squared minus 20w minus 12, and that equals zero. Now, I always look to see if I have a common factor, and I do. I do have a common factor. 4 will go into 8, and 4 will go into 20, and 4 will go into 12. But now, because we have an equation, and I can do the same thing to both sides of the equation, I can go ahead and divide out my greatest common factor. That will give me 2w squared minus 10w minus 3 equals 0. Aha! That's wrong. 4 into 20 is 5. Now it's going to be okay. All right. I will take my trusty calculator, and I will say x, no I won't. I will say a times c, so that's going to be 2 times negative 3. Okay, and now x plus 2 times negative 3 divided by x. Second graph. And our b number now is negative 5. 5 with a minus sign in front of it. Negative 5. So I am going to go through here looking for negatives. There's negative 5. And negative 5 is accompanied by negative 6 and 1. So that means I'm going to write 2w square minus 6 W plus 1W minus 3 equals 0. And now I'm going to factor by grouping. Put parentheses around the first two terms. Leave the plus sign in the middle. Put parentheses around the second two terms. Factor the first set of parentheses by the greatest common factor, which will be 2W. Times w minus 3 plus 1 times w minus 3 equals 0. See, there wasn't a GCF in there, so I put 1. Thank goodness the w minus 3 matches the w minus 3. That becomes my new GCF. I say w minus 3 times the leftovers, 2w plus 1. Then I set each factor equal to 0 and solve for w. W minus 3 equals 0. 2w plus 1 equals 0. So w equals negative 3, and 2w equals negative 1, and divide by 2 on both sides, so I'll have w equals negative 1/2. And those should be my answers. X equals, that's going to be positive 3. Positive 3 and negative 1/2. Let's see if that's right. Okay, negative 1/2. Hit my right arrow key, put a comma, and then 3. Move my calculator, check answer. Ooh, looks good. Yes. Okay, that is how you solve quadratic equations.